No money spent, no money spent, no money spent. One day a week. That's what we're going to do. We're going to play no money spent. I have not bought anything on this tag. No level packs, no legend packs, nothing. $0 are on this team. I'm only going to play on Mondays and weekend league. That's it. And I'm going to try to have a competitive team. I'm not going to play any solos. All I did was do the kickoff to get to level 50 that I showed you guys. No solos, no draft champions, straight head-to-head, one day a week. So little bit of time put in the game, just weekend league. I'm going to try to build this team. So I hope you guys are liking it, man. This was my second stream of No Money Spent, man. If you guys want to watch these games, they're absolutely pure entertainment. twitch.tv/dubdot. You guys know that link is below. Now, I'll be honest. It's rough. It is really, really rough. But I feel like if you grind, you can really build a team. Now, like I said, I'm not playing any solos. I hate solo. I hate playing a computer. It is mundane. It is terrible. If you're gonna give me 3,000 coins for playing a human and 10,000 playing a computer, I might lean to the human. But I did improve this team greatly. So we probably have a total of 20 games played with this account. Last stream I was 10-5. This stream I believe I was 8-2 this stream. It was great. I got a bunch of highlights to show you guys. But let's take a look at how I improved my team, man. If you guys don't remember what my team was, those last couple of videos, I'm going to keep these all in a playlist so you guys can watch my team. But let's go ahead and get into how I improved the team. And I used the team builders. The team builders are the best sets, the best cards you can add if you're going to be a budget team. I know you guys heard me praise Jerry Jeudy, and you're going to see in these highlights that he's pretty much the best budget card in the game, bar none. He's amazing. But let's go ahead and see what I did. Now, defense, we're pretty similar to how we were. We really didn't change anything. The main thing I did, I identified one defensive formation. I feel like kind of like salary cap, playing salary cap, it's easier when you only got to buy 11 players. Now, if you run multiple defenses, 3-4, dollar, nickel, now you have to get, you know, 6 DBs, 4 linebackers. You had to add so many more people. Now, I kind of just said, you know what, I'm going to find an in-between defense. We're just going to run nickel. That way we need no linebackers, really. We're going to use all safeties and corners. So we're going to use, what, 6-7 safeties and corners, and then we're going to use 4 linemen. Now, I'm using nickel normal. If you guys want this defense, man, MaddenTurf.com, this ebook will be out really soon. If you have the VIP membership, you guys will have access to that for sure. But I find a way to get my defensive ends at D-tackle and my linebackers at the end. So I have TJ Watt, I have Bradley Chubb. They're going to play defensive end for me. And then we're going to have Montez Sweat and the free DeMarcus Lawrence that we got. They're going to play D-tackle for me. Then we're going to have an outside shell of Dante Jackson and Denzel Ward, both of which are pretty tough for budget squad. Very, very fast, and they hold it down against the fastest Tyreek Hill as anybody out there. We're going to have Justin Reed, who is just barely fast enough, solid player, and we have Darnell Savage, who was fast enough, but honestly, he's a 75 overall for a reason. He looks like he's never played football when he's on the field. So sometimes I think maybe I should get somebody like a McCourty, who might be a little bit slower, but can also play some zones or something like that, so he doesn't just get thrown at all day. And then in the slot, we're going to keep this free Patrick Peterson. Now, he's a dog. You know he's my favorite corner in Madden. But he's going to play the slot, so we don't have to worry too much about him being 84 speed, and he's going to make some plays. User, we have Troy Apke. And we also have the number one user that I have, and you're going to see him make some plays, is the base Isaiah Simmons. Not the good one, just the rookie card, 76 overall. I think 84 speed. Not fast. He's still tall. He's still a big body. He's still dumb. It's rough. I did pick up Grant Delpit, and you see I have 41,000 coins. That's probably enough to get another team builder. I did not play a game yet with Grant Delpit. I'm going to probably put him at user. I'm looking to get Edmonds and Jeremy Chin as well. These team builders can really build your team, but let's take a look at the offense, because that's where I put all my effort in last night during, you know, this 6-hour stream. I added so many pieces. Before I just had Ruggs, I had Lamar Miller running back, and I had Evan Ingram at tight end. After this stream, I wound up upgrading to Cam Akers at running back, another team builder, absolute stud. If you guys don't have him, you're struggling at running back, and you don't want to spend $300K for Work Done or a million for Barry Sanders, Cam Akers is your guy. He's agile, he's fast. I can't say enough about how good he is. Jonnu Smith, the fastest tight end in the game. Once again, I mean, I honestly feel like Finley's one of the best cards in the game. But if you don't have Finley, Jonnu Smith is the next card. And then I got Tyler Lockett. I have the full Tyler Lockett. How did I get the full Tyler Lockett? It cost me about 300 training and two of my power-up passes. But I was able to get the full Tyler Lockett. And if we take a look at the full Tyler Lockett, he's sitting here at 89 speed. 89 speed for a card. Actually, really good route running. You know he's agile after the catch. So if I put him with Jerry Jeudy and Ed McCaffrey, I think that's a three solid wide receivers. Now, all these cards aren't in the game at the same time. You know, I built these cards up game after game. But like I said, and I'll show you guys the team builder set. The team builder set, honestly, I mean, if you guys are playing some type of budget team or some type of trying to save coins or make coins or anything like that, I feel like it is the best set in the game for making coins. For me, we go Team Infinity, we go right here, Team Builders, Series, and we go this team builder. You get an 84 overall, man. So you're gonna get six golds, 77 to 79, and two low elites. If you can get the six golds for 3K, right, then you're looking at what, 18,000 for the golds, and then each of the elites could be 10K, so that's 20,000. So for a cool 38K, you can get one of these 84 overalls, Jonnu Smith, Cam Akers, Jerry Jeudy, Grant Delpit. You can get AJ Terrell from the Falcons. Trey Waynes is another great option. Jeremy Chin, this safety from the Panthers, is another one that's on my radar. So if you're struggling to make coins, if you're trying to find new players for your team and you don't want to spend money and you don't want to grind solos, this is a great way to add these cards. And they made a huge impact on my team. Like I showed you guys, man, Jerry Jeudy, I honestly want to put him on my main team. He's been that good. But I will show you guys, man, it is definitely tough to play these games with this low team. And part of it, it's a pet peeve of mine. A lot of my friends growing up, man, or that I played Madden with for the last 15 years are kind of out of Madden because they think it costs too much money. One, it does cost money, you know, it does, but it also costs a lot of time. And honestly, if you're not willing to put in the time or the money, I don't think you should be able to compete on the highest level. You know, I think it's got to be one or the other. And this team, I'm actually not putting up either. No money and really not a lot of time. And I want to show that it's able to be done if you're really good enough at the game. You know, and I think that's a big thing I want to show everybody, that you can compete without spending a dime or without having 15 hours to play every single day. And that's one of my goals with this series. I hope you guys are liking it. Hit the like button. Let's get into some of these highlights for the stream if you guys missed No Money Mondays. All right, first game of the day, we hold my man to a fourth down. We're down by seven, got to make a play, got to get off the field. And my man right here, Darnell Savage, comes up with a huge pick in man coverage. We are down by seven. And I'll tell you, the good thing about No Money Monday, I'm in a hell game with everybody. So make sure you guys tune in. I'm on a money drive now, have to make a play. And we find that man, Jerry Jeudy, right up the middle of the field. Touchdown. We tied the game up with the rookie out of Alabama. Now we got to hold my man right here. We got to hold him back. And I will be honest, stopping the run with these bad linebackers and bad D linemen is rough. And that's what he goes to, a little bit of inside zone, picks up a couple yards, nothing crazy, but he's getting 10 yards a carry. Next play, dumps it off to the running back. I got to keep him out of field goal range right here. He hits me with the no huddle, gets to the line. I'm worried about the inside zone, and he goes ahead and he hits this little pass play, but he hits a play action. I bite on it, he hits over top to Kittle in the field goal range. So we got to see if he cares about ice. I mean, this guy is not going to hit an ice field goal, you know, a 47-yard ice field goal, but he does. And we lose the first game of No Money Spent Monday. But we've been down before, we step back up. Next game, my man Isaiah Simmons, that rookie card, gets a huge interception early in the second quarter, takes this one to the crib. 84 speed Isaiah Simmons. He's a budget player, not very good. But you see him here again. Huge play right there, Isaiah Simmons. I wish I had the real one on my team, on my budget team. Might be a goal for me down the line. We're winning this game by a cool 12 points. And then Jamar Taylor, the rookie out of Indianapolis, taking one to the Baja to seal the victory right here. But that's why I picked up Akers. Before this game, I had Lamar Miller and that Jamar Taylor. And here we see him a little rollout in the next game. That's that speed, that Darnell Savage, man. He's not the best in coverage, but makes a huge play right there. Gets it done, gets me the ball back. Evan Engram in tight end breaks a tackle right there, but fumbles to the crib. And after that play, Jonnu Smith was picked up pretty much after this game, because I need a better tight end to make some plays. But here we go with Ed McCaffrey tying the ball game up. Big body, slot receiver, touchdown. Great player. We see a goal line here from him next drive, and I told you, man, stopping these Bo Jacksons with these 90 offensive linemen is a little bit rough, I'll be honest. But we hit Ed McCaffrey, get inside the 1 yard line, last play of the first half. We're going to go try to do a little play action right here, but his corner swats it away. We get no points, down 14-6 right here, and we're kicking off. It's looking rough. Like I said, they only show kickoff for two reasons, either a good thing or a bad thing. And for me, this here was a bad thing, as he's going to take this to the crib with Tyreek Hill, and nobody on my team is in the screen. That's a bad thing. Tyreek Hill is a little bit too fast for me. So we're down by 14. Got to make some plays. Who do we go to? Jerry Jeudy, touchdown, bang. Any offense you see, MaddenTurf.com, the ebook is out now, because this man, Jerry Jeudy, is on fire this game. Big play right there, 74-yard touchdown, Jerry Jeudy, tie the game up. Once again, we go RPO, Jerry Jeudy into the end zone, his third touchdown of the game. This card is insane, I'm telling you. I'm going to put him on my real team. Have to hold this guy out of the end zone right here. Get him to a 4th and 30, he goes up top. Denzel Ward, you're not going to get behind that guy. Pick to seal that game. Get into the next game. We're down by 7 early. Who else is going to catch a touchdown for me but Jerry Jeudy? Again, RPO. This time the Ruggs to the end zone. That's that speed, but he's been replaced by Tyler Lockett. We give up an inside zone for this man to take the lead right here, but we got to get down. We're going to go ahead and find Jerry Jeudy right there. It looks like he kind of let me score to give him a chance to get the ball back, and he's going to run a little inside zone as we see Simmons holding him up right there. Got to make a play in the secondary. He throws the Kittle right there. I'm a little bit slow. I don't have a 90 speed user, a 92 speed at least. Gets a spike, no time left on the clock, 17 seconds. He throws the out route. We're playing really passive. Prevent defense prevents you from winning sometimes, as he has 12 seconds left in the game. He's going to throw it underneath right here to Heath Miller. I click on, make sure nobody, you're not getting outside. GG's, game's over. We win that one. Next game, we're going to get into this one. This guy actually had 5 O-line chems, so I was a little bit scared right here as we hit the C route over here to Ruggs. Inside the 5-yard line. Read option inside the end zone. Goes Lamar Jackson as we take a lead here. 14-10. Get a ball to Cam Akers inside the 2-minute warning. He's going to seal this victory for me. I get this win. It was pretty easy. Now we're in the playoffs. My first playoff game with this team. Cam Akers getting outside. Touchdown early. We take a 7-0 lead. And right here, we're going to give up a angle route to the running back Cam Akers. And Denzel Ward, I love you, buddy, but you got to make that tackle. And Justin Reed, you just don't have the speed to catch Cam Akers. He scores a touchdown on that one. This one, he's going to take off with Lamar, and we're getting blocked by wide receivers, and we get just Justin Reed gets juked, and we cannot catch Lamar Jackson. Another huge touchdown. We're down by 3. Got to make some plays here before the half. Who else but Jerry Jeudy? I'm telling you, if you guys watch this and you don't have this man, you are tripping. Even if he's a backup on your team, he has to be somewhere. Right here, we're up by 4. He's going to roll out, hit a throw on the run in the back of the end zone to Mark Clayton. Touchdown. I'm down by 3. He actually is going to go for a fake here for some reason. He's insane. So now I'm only down by 2. Perfect time to waste 4 minutes, run the clock, and kick a field goal. That's what we're going to try to do here. We're going to try to establish some clock. We're going to try to, you know, milk this down so we kick a game-winning field goal, because he went for that fake. Questionable decision, but we got to take advantage of him making mistakes. Lamar out of the pocket. Ed McCaffrey, Big Ed, with a huge gain. We're close to field goal range now. Read option, and Grady Jarrett just disengaged. Oh, that was almost a touchdown right there. Once again, we're going to hit Cam Akers underneath. I told you, man, that guy gets busy. 2-minute warning, 3rd and 3. We're going to run a read option, and we get to a 4th down. Got to go for it. We're not kicking now. We see man coverage. We're at the line. He's going to bring a blitz. I see that as the offensive mind I am. Max Protect. Motion out Jerry Jeudy. We see him on the right side. We're going to go to our new acquisition, Tyler Lockett, and boop! 4th down. This is how we lose the game. In the playoffs. Just like that. I mean, that happens. You know, it's obviously, I've done that route a million times, and that's a rare occurrence. Sucks it was in the playoffs. But Tyler Lockett has been balling. I've only played, I think, 2 games with him. He's been really good. But Jerry Jeudy, I can't tell you guys enough about how good this card is. So if you don't have him on your team, please add it, man. If there's any players you guys think I should add to the No Money Squad, or No Money Spent Squad, please let me know in the comments, man. I hope you guys are really liking this series. It has been a struggle, but it's a blast trying to play with a budget squad.